That's it, teacher!
Oh, hello, dearie.
How could you do this to me?
What?
You ran my restaurant into the ground!
Well, I don't see how I could
have... You stole all of my customers!
Well, don't be so...
No, literally, they live there now! Do you know how embarrassing that is for me?
Oh, sweetie, it can't be that bad.
I've had to get a second job as a hunter just to make ends meet!
Oh, shut up, you little twerp, and go find something better to do.
I'll show you. I'll be the best chef slash hunter the world has ever seen, and I know just what weapon I'll use to get there.
Ladies, gentlemen, and monsters of all ages, I know it's only been a month since the last time, but Capcom can't stop injecting beautiful, wondrous, delicious content into this game. And with the festival just starting, there are a number of new pieces of equipment you hunters might have your eyes on. This one, however, is mine! Mine! None of you can have it!
Meat?
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, it's finally time to get properly silly, as in the game we finally have a proper food-based weapon, the juicy, well-done hammer. It's beautiful, isn't it? Well, thankfully, it doesn't have to only be beautiful in this video, it can also be beautiful in your game and in your hunter's hands, if you follow a few simple steps. If you wish to acquire this hunk of flesh and bone, then you need look no further than the event quest, Beef is Never a Mistake, which sees you hunt Glavinus and Ebneo Dogra on the Wildspire Wastes. The quest itself isn't all that hard, and unless you get lucky and get multiple tickets in one go, you will have to complete the quest a whopping 3 times to get enough tickets to unlock the fully upgraded version of this weapon. Though it only takes 1 to get the smithy to say,
"Looks like meat's back on the menu, boys!"
Okay, I'm sorry, enough with the meat jokes. So getting down to the meat of the matter, the actual weapon statistics. How is it? How does it compare to the other hammers? Well, 1612 is actually excellent raw, if it wasn't for the fact that this weapon is locked at blue sharpness, and the fire damage is pretty poor, too, with only 210. This shouldn't really come as a surprise, but this weapon isn't really all that high up there if you're just looking to bash heads in as effectively and as efficiently as possible. However, if what you want is to have a stellar time with an absolutely amazing looking weapon, this thing is fantastic. It's actually hilarious to me that after all this time, and after all of the complaining from the community about all these metal and bone weapons, the weapon that actually makes me the most excited is literally a bone with some meat on it. Capcom, thank you for bringing this gorgeous monstrosity of a weapon to the new world, and I for one look forward to any food weapons that you release in the future. I'm looking at you, Pizza Charge Blade.
Pizza time.
Alright everyone, I've been Cotton Dinosaur and this has been everything you need to know about the juicy, well-done hammer, also known as the Meat Stick Beat Stick. Do you like this weapon? What other silly weapons could you see Capcom bringing us in the future? Like if you like this video, subscribe to the notification bell for more, and most importantly, ladies and gentlemen, until next time, stay sweet. This is the brand new outro to tell you all the things that you do that we love. So let's start with something simple and say, oh, we love your eyes. When they're watching us play video games, when we make a bunch of jokes that are kinda lame, or when they gaze upon our failures as we try to kill the monsters or report important news about the Kingdom Animalia. Rage, Cotton, and Hollow are all here talking about the things you want to hear. So if you want to be the first to hear, like and subscribe and the bell and we'll cheer. Some of you are patrons even though we are all the noobs and you're the pros. There's nothing we can do to thank you. No, really, there's nothing we could possibly do. Goodbye.